Welcome back to Throwback Thursday, where our family attends, share memories from the past and things that happened. Well, today, my memory is when my kids were 10 and under, and all I felt like I did was pick up toys, do laundry. I couldn't even brush my hair or get my teeth brushed. My name's Heather, and I'm married to Luke. I have two beautiful daughters and six handsome sons, and this is Just the Bells 10.
So basically, it was back in like probably 2010. No, like 2012, because I would have been 10. And I had this birthday party, and there was 10 candles on the cake. It was nuts. It was nuts. Or absolute rager. There's ice cream. Oh my goodness. That's it. It's the story of my life.
I remember one time when we were living at the rental before we were adopted. It was probably 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock in the morning. Me and Rob got in a fight, like a big fight. Like we were yelling at each other. And then Rob gets me in the and starts choking me, right? And I was probably like 8, right? So then I told Rob, because he was choking me and I couldn't breathe, you know, it's like, told Rob to go to HE Double Hockey Sticks.
That's really bad.
Why would you tell that story?
I wanted to share a little bit about Robert and Brendan's scenes, how this Throwback Thursday is them sharing memories. When Robert and Brendan came into our home, Brendan came in very angry and just very emotional. And he would get angry really easy and he would cry really easy because he really just didn't understand what had happened with their dad passing suddenly. And so I just made sure to give him lots of hugs. Like he needed lots of hugs, lots of reassurance. But in the same part, he was also so funny. Like he has a ton of different voices he does. And he just always was making us laugh. And I truly believe that the reason he makes us laugh is it was a way for him to not be angry and frustrated over his dad passing. And so I think the only thing he knew to do was to just bring laughter to our family. I honestly can't picture my life without Brendan. He seriously brings so much laughter and happiness to our family. He walks in and right away you just smile because he's just such a funny person. And I think that came from him really dealing with the anger and the frustration and the sadness of losing his dad. And I'm very thankful for that he did choose laughter and happiness instead of anger and resentment. And I just hope that he decides to live by me because he just has brought so much laughter into our family.
Robert, memory.
So, this was a couple days before Christmas. And
4 days to be exact.
4 days to be exact before Christmas. And you know, I was in charge of the wood stove and everything, but one morning I asked my brother to go fill it. So he's like, yeah, I'll fill it for you.
I offered to fill it.
He's starting to do all the chores and stuff. He comes back and he's crying and screaming and words aren't coming out of his mouth. And so superhero Rob understands what he's saying, somehow runs to the barn in no shoes, no socks, puts the fire out. I'm just a superhero.
I thought the barn burned down.
It did.
How'd you put the fire out? And I thought it was me. I thought I was the first one.
So basically what actually happened is I came home, right? And I said, the barn's on fire. My mom says, no, it's not. Come inside. I said, Mom, barn's on fire. She said, no, cooking pancakes. Let's go. Nana's coming down the stairs. Oh, just in time for breakfast. I said, no, barn's on fire. Rob, face full of pancakes. The barn's on fire? Runs out the door, barefoot. Who runs out in the middle of winter barefoot? Completely useless, right? Gets to the barn. Oh, the barn's on fire. Then what does he do? Absolutely nothing, because he's barefoot.
I put it out.
Then he's barefoot.
I put my cape on.
I remember you coming to the door crying, the barn's on
bawling
fire.
Bawling his eyes
and
out.
And I my ran eyes out, and
words
your hand
weren't
was
coming
burned,
off of his tongue.
And I ran over, we opened the door, and the barn was on fire.
No. So then we get to the barn, right? Rob's got to run all the way back and put shoes on.
No, so, I never put shoes on.
Oh.
Never.
You sat in the horse barn. And we went out there and we opened the doors and pushed all the chickens out.
Oh, I helped.
Yeah. I opened the big doors. He opened the little door.
Because I'm huge and
he's little.
I thought the fire department sprayed the chickens.
Well, we got a bunch out. And then we couldn't get any more out because they were huddling down.
Where was I?
So then they took
my recollection.
Hey, I actually started it on fire, so I actually know the story.
Can you say that one more time?
I actually burnt the barn down. Okay. I hate chickens. Okay. I'm going to do it again.
You do not hate chickens.
I'm going to get an insurance claim. BSB
Stop
Farms.
It. We didn't get an insurance claim at all. It wasn't even covered.
BSB Farms / crematorium coming your way.
Stop it. I don't remember it that way. I do remember running out there and...
He actually had a flamethrower.
You guys.
I actually put it out with a lip full of Gatorade I had.
You know, Mr. Freeze? That was me. Trying to put it out. Trying to save the chickens. No shoes. No socks. I can't do it all.
Let's just say, if Rob went to Sky High High School, he would have been a sidekick and I would have been a hero.
Ooh.
He would have been a villain. You burnt the chicken barn down.
Intentionally? Now look what we got. I was trying to provide for the family, Rob.
Oh, that's not a memory. That's fake.
That's a core memory.
That is fake.
Yeah, now you're getting a little absurd.
I did it intentionally.
You're getting absurd.
I did it intentionally.
Yeah, that he did.
You see how many chores we have to do now? You don't even have to feed the chickens anymore. You're welcome. You don't have to fill the wood stove anymore. You're welcome.
I like doing all that.
Oh, I'm sure you did. That's why you don't do it anymore.
Because if you don't have to.
You could fill the wood stove.
And when Robert came into our home, he was the one that took care of his brothers and took care of his mom and his dad when they were struggling. So when he came into our home, he felt like he needed to protect me. So he would always remind me that we had appointments or remind me we have to do this or ask me if I need help or he'd help me in the kitchen. He never left my side, but he also never left his dad's side. And he just is a very loyal person. And so one of my sweetest memories was, actually I have two memories of Robert. The first memory was when we were on our way home. And I know I've shared this before. He goes, Mom, don't forget we have to do this. Don't forget we have to do this. And he always sat in the front seat because he wanted to be by me. Whenever I went anywhere, he would come with me. And he hugged me all the time. And he always had to be right beside me. And we were in the car and he says, Mom, we got to do this. And I looked at him and I said, Robert, I'm going to take care of you. I'm always going to be here for you. You can now just be a kid. And he just looked at me and you could just see the peace. Sorry about that. Sorry about that. That's my phone. You could just see the peace on his face and like tears started to come down his face because he has always been the one to take care of people. And now I told him I'm here for him and you can now be a kid. And that was just a very sweet moment for the both of us.
I just said it. That's why I said it.
All right, Brandon has another memory.
Don't be a weenie.
What's the other memory? It has to go with what just happened. Oh, yeah.
I remember one time. Here's a good one for you. Mom and Dad were gone, right? These people that go to our church, we're not going to tell you Christine's name. But she was over here, right? She was babysitting. And the little boys were in one room. And Rob and Dave, the big boys, were in the other room, right? And we kept knocking on the big boys' door. And they kept opening it and scaring us, you know? So they thought it would be great, right? Rob would open the door. Dave would flash the dark side of the moon to the little kids opening the door. Little did they know, it was the unnameable Christine babysitter. She opens the door, skadoosh, chocolate moon, square to the cry balls. Never gonna forget that one.
David mooned my babysitter, Christine.
Yeah, the unnameable one.
Wow, I need to tell them the end. Who was fault was it?
Definitely me and Gideon. It was our fault.
You guys set up David and the babysitter.
Oh, yeah. It was great.
I opened the door.
Yeah, Rob opened the door.
Robert opened the door.
And then Dave, scrunch!
So who was he supposed to moon?
Me and Gideon. Because they kept scaring us when he'd open the door.
I didn't know that one? How come I'm just hearing about it right now?
Oh, I don't know. I thought Dave got in trouble for it, but maybe not.
I just don't
know. And my second memory of Robert is when we had went to visit my mom in the summer. They had been with us for about 6 months. And like I said before, he always helped me. He was always like my go-to guy. And still today, he comes in, hugs me right away. He wants me to rub his head or to hug him or to, you know, he just really he's just like that kind of boy. And so we were unloading the groceries or the bags or whatever. And I said, here you go. And he goes, Mom, can I help you? And I was like, and I looked at him and I go, you called me Mom. He goes, yeah, Mom, I'm trying. I want to call you Mom. And I was like, oh my goodness. And tears ran down my face. And shortly after that, probably a month after that, Brendan called me Mom, because I think Brendan wanted to call us Mom and Dad right away, but he wanted that reassurance from Robert that it was okay, because Brendan looks up to his brother Robert, you know. And what's so sweet is Robert and Brendan, their dad actually was a friend of ours and he worked for our company, and they actually lived in the rental. And so when his dad passed, his dad, he went for a nap, and of course he never woke up. And I remember we were at a Clydesdale show in Madison, and we had found out, and I said, we got to go home. And this was when they were living next to us. So we packed our bags at like, I don't know, 8, 9 o'clock at night, drove all the way home. And I remember walking in the house and they were laying on their couch, and I walked in and just hugged both of them. And they were just really struggling. And so anyway, what I was trying to say with that is, so now the boys actually live in our rental again. So where they had lived before and we met them, they now live there now. So yeah, that's a couple memories of Robert and Brendan, but I'm so thankful they're in our home because they really do complete our family. And I just love them so much.
Okay, so you're 15, you got a brand new pair of waders.
Yeah, I wanted to try them out. We couldn't go fishing yet. So we just decided to make a couple of YouTube hit videos. We still need to post. We're waiting for the 10-year anniversary. So stick around for 6 more years.
You can
years.
Post them on our new YouTube, Just the Bells 10.
I say we do it, yeah.
I'm just going to let you know, when I slid through that puddle and I came up, my badonkadonks were wet and they was looking thick with 3 C's. Like, thick.
And a Q.
And a Q. Thick. Like that.